Hello guys, Anik here, and today I'm gonna review Wi-Fi Slacks 4.9. I'm gonna live boot it, and it is based on Slackware, as you all know. The ISO file is universal, and it can be installed on 32-bit and 64-bit versions. The ISO file is 734.0 MB, and the OS is mainly used for hacking Wi-Fi's and passwords all around your network. As you can see, it is a live CD, so I can check this out if I want. So it looks like this. So I'm gonna quickly live boot it and check it out what's there inside. Let's create a new virtual machine. It is the final version actually. So I'm gonna check this out, what it looks like and what are the functions in the OS itself. I'm creating a new hard disk here of 40 GB. I'm gonna increase the CPU cores for faster processing. I'm gonna increase the display also to 100 MB. I'm gonna start this and I'm gonna select the ISO file that is downloaded. Here's the ISO file, just double click it and start it. So here we have different options, not a different option, you have a language, different language. So I'm gonna change to English menus. So here you have two options, I guess. Yes. Your first one is of to boot with a normal kernel. Second one is to boot with a PAE kernel. So you can check it on what kernel you want to boot. Show your key. It's nice when your system have more 4 GB of RAM memory. So I'm gonna go boot with a PAE kernel. So I have an option here to boot with a KDE interrupt, and to boot with KDE plus persistent, to boot with XFCE and so on. So I'm gonna boot with the XFCE plus persistent. Okay, so I'm gonna boot with the XFCE desktop with no persistent, and let's see what we get to see inside. Right, we are here, booted up in the OS, and here it what it looks like. It is a beautiful OS. UI is good. It seems awesome. Here's a file manager here. You can check it out if you want. And yes, it is the live boot CD, as obviously. Let's check out the apps. In the development, you have these apps. The QT4 is pre-installed. Glade, I don't know what's that. In the graphics, we have screenshot, you have Ristretto image viewer as your default image viewer. In the internet, you have Firefox pre-installed, you have Conky's pre-installed, you have Avahi VNC web server browser pre-installed. In the multimedia, you have ISO Master pre-installed, XMMS, you have GTK Record My Desktop pre-installed, you have Audio Mixer. In the office, you have PDF view for viewing PDF files. In the system, you have Adobe Flash Player pre-installed. You have XFCE terminal. You have Gparted. You have Salix tools. Okay, so you can check this out if you want. And so here is an option to install the Grub2 and Wi-Fi Slacks installer. Okay, I'm not gonna do the installation now. You have theme changer here also, GTK theme changer. And the Thunder file manager, okay, it's a default one, okay. In the utilities, you have these keyboards in the desktop. You have these in the editors, you have mousepad editor in the maintenance. You have these apps. Let's check out the settings here. You have Bluetooth manager, desktop file manager, MIME type editor. Okay. Let's check out other things also. So as you can see, the browser is also in different language, so you have to change it to your own language. So okay, let's check out some other things also. So as I said, the OS is obviously before hacking Wi-Fi and all. So you have these options here, so you can check it out if you want. You can Google on how to use Wi-Fi slacks. It will give you detailed information on how to hack Wi-Fi and wireless networks and all. So you can obviously check it out. Okay, so here is the full package of hacking a Wi-Fi network. You have been given all the things here, and that's quite good. As you can see, you have a lot of options. You have decryptors, you have hardware tools to manage the passwords. So you have a lot of options here, and yes, as you can see, there are a lot of options you can actually test upon. You have Aircrack pre-installed, which is usually used for receiving packets for hacking a Wi-Fi network. You have these. You have tutorials also, you can check them out also. Again, a lot of apps. You have apps for WPA also. You have apps for WPAP, but WPS also. So you can obviously check it out. That's quite cool. I won't be doing a tutorial on how to hack a Wi-Fi network or any wireless network. I'm just showing you the applications here which are you get with the OS. So it will be useful for you. So you can check it out if you want or not. So I guess that's it. You can check out the OS yourself only, or if you have any questions or you want me to review something particular in this OS, I can make a separate video also. So for now, then I'm gonna shut this down, and it will be fine. Play. Okay. So let's shut this down, I guess. Okay, let me check out the. Okay, there is a pretty same amount of memory usage here. Okay, memory usage is quite less, not more, so it will be fine. Java control panel. Okay, so I'm gonna shut this down now. Okay, thanks for watching. Please rate, comment and subscribe, and do watch my next videos for the review. So okay, I'll let it get shut down. Thanks for watching. Please rate, comment and subscribe, and do watch my next videos. Peace.